Hi, YouTubers. Sorry. I've been busy with work. I've been busy with so much this holiday season. I haven't had a chance to post a video or do anything this holiday season. So, Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays to everybody. Let's talk about the PowerA Pro Controller 2 for the Xbox Series console. Now, a few weeks ago, I did a review of this controller. This is the PowerA Fusion controller. I really like this controller. It's well built, has a nice locking USB cable so that you can't rip it out and screw up the controller port. But it was missing some things. It really needed more faceplates, which they never released. It needed better grips on the front grips here. And then it needed basically just a few little tweaks. It wasn't bad. It's not a bad controller. And if you have an Xbox One, these are nice wired controllers for the $85. You get a nice carrying case with it. You get the paddles, which are removable off of the backside. And you have to remove the paddles in order to put it in its case. That's kind of the drawback of this design. And we'll get into that when we start reviewing the second one. First thing I like is presentation of packaging. And we're going to talk about the difference because PowerA actually learned from their packaging mistakes. And I'll show you what I mean by packaging mistake. So this is the PowerA Fusion original box. I keep my box, but now watch this because this is where this gets really, really stupid. I open the box. That's where the controller goes in. I shut the box. The box doesn't shut. Why? Because the plastic tab that comes out the top here is actually on this box. It's attached to the top here. So once you open this, you can't shut the box again. Real pain in the butt, stupid packaging. Good packaging that it protected the controller and shipment, but that's about it. Then we get into the Fusion Pro 2. And they fix the packaging flaw. The tab is actually attached to the main box, and the slide out is actually turned sideways instead of out the bottom. Love this. Nice box design. That gets 1 star for box and packaging. Now, let's get into the problems. The difference between the two controllers is not only a share button, but the fact that they upgraded the controller to USB-C. Now, if you're wondering why this is a bad idea, I'm going to explain it really quick. The original PowerA cable for the first series Fusion controllers actually lock into the front of the controller. It's so that you don't damage the micro USB cable port on your controller and break the controller. Physically break the controller, ladies and gentlemen. So I was like, great, a locking USB cable. Thank you. It's locked, it's secured, there's no problems there. None of that garbage. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. I was just happy that they had that locking USB cable. And they have a nice breakaway. So if you trip the cable, pink, it comes unplugged. Thank you. Again, nice cable design. Let's go into the Series 2 cable. Cheapo USB-C cable, still braided, but no locking mechanism on here. Now, if you're wondering with the Model 2 controller why this is a problem, it goes along with the USB cable. And I want you to see this on camera. See the problem? Notice the wobble? Now let's go ahead and say, I'm playing a game. Oh yeah, I'm kicking butt in Forza. and somebody comes by and trips this cable hard this way, you are going to snap that cable off inside the port. Or worse, you're going to break the USB-C port on the inside of this controller immediately, because this is not a locking cable. This doesn't lock. Bad design there. So the first thing I'd recommend is upgrading to a better USB-C cable and getting off of their cheap A cable. At that point, that is downfall and a complete turn off on me on the USB cable presentation for this controller. That gets a negative 1 star. Now let's talk about the design here. I love this. We now have volume control on the front, which is awesome. So you can control volume. You have your share button, your plus and minus, you know, start, select, whatever you want to call it. They put this really nice grip surface on the front, and they put this really nice grip surface on the back. Now, if you remember from the first controller, there is no grip surface on the front, but the grip surface is on the back, which is really weird. They really should have put it on the front. We got new black metal paddle shifters. And it still has the same program button and adjustable stops for your triggers. What they changed, which is nice, is there's actual grip material. And I don't know if you can see this on camera. The grip material is right here on the triggers. So when you got your finger on this, this sucker's got grip on both triggers. I am very pleased with this because I love the grip surface on this. It still is magnetic, so you can basically take your faceplate off. And in the case of this controller, there's a reason why. So PowerA never released faceplates for this controller, the Xbox One version of the Fusion controller. And that really was sad, because if you have an Xbox One S, then you wanted it to be white, you really couldn't. They listened to that. And not in a good way. So the first thing that they did is they updated the case so that now you can leave these paddle shifters on the back of the controller. They did listen on that, because on the original first controller, you have to take the paddle shifters off and put them in the case separately. In this case, you don't have to. This just drops right into the case and you're done and you're out of the way. Great controller, like I said, still works great. What they added, which pissed me off, for $85 for this controller, they could have at least done the one thing that I was hoping they would have done with their faceplate. Now, take a look at what I love on the front of this controller. Grip. Thank you. Thank you for the grip. But I will be leaving this controller on the black faceplate. Now, I know you're all wondering why. You want to see what they did with the white faceplate? Where in the hell is the grip material? Really? For $85, you took the grip material off of the white faceplate. Don't you think the white faceplate would have looked badass with this grip material on it? I sure do. I thought this faceplate would look absolutely awesome with this nice grip material on it. And instead, we get this white, hot, garbage, cheap plastic replacement front for the controller that is literally hot garbage. So if you don't mind one hot garbage component, this isn't a bad controller. This is the only downfall besides the USB cable. Two things: crap USB cable, crap faceplate. That's it. That's my review. Can I recommend this controller? Yes, if you want a nice wired controller. They're both wonderful controllers. They both work with the Xbox Series console. Quite shockingly. And that's pretty much it. The Pro 2 is close, but that cable is a deal breaker. And the Fusion 1 can still be bought new, and it has a much better USB cable. I'm sorry, I'm torn to basically buy an Xbox One controller and use it on the Series versus buying the Series controller and using it on the Series, because that thing, to have that hot garbage USB-C port and the hot garbage replacement faceplate, is really a turnoff, and you might as well just spend the $85 on the Xbox One controller version as a Fusion controller. Sorry. Thank you.